Hello and welcome to New Mexico's Naturopathic Medical Show. I'm Dr. Wendy Anita Van Dilla, naturopathic doctor and your host. In the studio today with me is a wonderful entrepreneur here in Santa Fe, New Mexico. She started off not with a terrible situation where she needed surgery, and she ended up being an incredible businesswoman here in Santa Fe. So we're going to hear Kelly Egolf's story of from jaw surgery to selling excellent juices and foods to us people here in Santa Fe. So thank you for coming on, Kelly.
Thank you very much for having me, Wendy.
And how long have you been in Santa Fe?
We've been living in New Mexico for about 15 years. My husband grew up here, and I met him in Washington, D.C., and followed him out here.
Okay, and who is your husband, by the way, for those who don't know New Mexico politics?
My husband's Brian Egolf. He represents Santa Fe in the state legislature and is the Speaker of the State House.
And according to my 98-year-old father, he's fantastic.
He is fantastic.
Excellent. So you met him in Washington, D.C. He's from here originally.
He's from Santa Fe. He loves Santa Fe, and I knew it from our very first date that he eventually wanted to move back here. So I was more than happy to follow along.
Great. And where are you originally from?
I'm an Army brat. So my family's from Western Pennsylvania, but I've never actually lived there.
Have you been, did you live overseas?
A little bit. So when I was in kindergarten, we were in Germany, and I attended a German kindergarten, and then that sparked an international interest. So I actually traveled abroad a little bit, did an exchange as a high school student, as a college student, joined the Peace Corps, and went overseas for a few years to the former Soviet Union.
Oh my gosh.
And then met Brian shortly after that.
Oh wow. Mm-hmm. So you have a strong background in different cultures.
Indeed. Well, and in the Peace Corps, I was doing a lot around health. We actually opened a health education center, so it's always been a passion of mine to help people find balance in their lives.
Excellent. And what happened with your surgery?
So I suffered from really terrible TMJ. My joints were beginning to deteriorate as a result of a condition that runs in my family. It's a recessed jawline, where my lower jaw was pushed back, if you will, and exerting too much pressure on the joints, which was causing the deterioration. But it also created chronic pain and terrible sleep apnea, because the recessed jawline was cutting my airway to about one-third of the typical airway. So it was like breathing through a straw all of the time. So I wasn't sleeping well at night, and when you don't sleep well, you don't function well during the day, and you add chronic pain onto that. So I sought natural therapies for about 10 years, trying to avoid surgery, and finally gave in and said, just do the surgery. And I was really glad that I did it. It was life-altering to get the pain source resolved, but it also led to a path that none of us had anticipated.
Which was, how do you feed yourself when you can't use your teeth?
That's it. So the story I always tell everyone, which is really interesting, the surgery was done in Texas, and my husband was with me, and we went for that last meeting with the doctor, and he slid a can of Ensure across the table at us, and at this point he's talking to my husband more than he was me, because he knew after the surgery I wasn't really going to be making too many decisions about what I was putting in my body, and he looks at my husband and he says, don't just go buy this at the grocery store, stock up on it, buy it by the case. This will be your sole source of nutrition for the next 2 months, because everything that you get must be liquid. I had a tube. I couldn't even use a straw initially, so I had to force feed myself with a tube. And he says, drink Ensure. This will be your sole source of nutrition. Have your mother come and take care of my then very little, two little girls. And you're going to be in bed for 2 months, and just know that that's what life is going to be like, because you're trying to heal from major surgery, plus you're not getting any nutrition in your body, so you won't have any energy, so you won't be able to do anything. So just know that now. And so I looked at the, and have you ever looked at the back of a can of Ensure?
Describe it for those who haven't.
It's basically like 99% 0.9% high fructose corn syrup.
Yes.
I mean, it's sugar, 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 but not even decent sugar. It's like chemically engineered, terrible stuff. But then they add vitamins and minerals, which are pharmaceutically engineered, so they're not mm-hmm. natural either. Mm-hmm. And that's what the nutrition part is of the Ensure. So it's basically just sugar water.
It's fake nutrition.
It's absolutely terrible. And in my opinion, that much sugar is really toxic for the body, and it's the worst way to try to heal from anything, let alone major surgery.
Yep.
So I slid the can back over, and I said, thanks, Doc, very much. We can do better than that. So we packed up our Vitamix blender, and I was just a casual juicer prior to the surgery, but I knew I had to go on a liquid diet, and I knew that I wanted it to be primarily plant-based, and I knew that I wanted to avoid all of the fake foods, the protein powders, the junky stuff that you can put in your body that cause inflammation. I wanted to get rid of my inflammation. So we took the blender. Yeah.
So let's show the first slide.
Yeah.
Kelly, the local hero.
Oh.
So you went from being a passive patient mm-hmm. to saying, I can do better. We can do better.
Yes, indeed.
That's a hero to me.
Thank you. Thank you. Well, the frustrating part was that once I had gotten out of surgery, there wasn't anything that we could turn to. There wasn't anything on the market that would fit my need. If I was buying juice, it was pasteurized, junky mm-hmm. stuff. So boiled down to a sugar content, most pasteurized juices are anyway. Smoothies were thick and globby, and I wanted something in between. And it wasn't out there, so I created my own line of juice blends that were much more nutritious.
And let's go to the next, because you've got some beautiful photographs the produce that's being used and the combination that goes into these different juices that you've developed. And we have access to some of these excellent juices. They're cold pressed, and mm-hmm. we'll get into that a little bit later.
Mm-hmm.
So you wanted something that was highly nutritious,
mm-hmm.
fresh,
mm-hmm.
Gorgeous.
Had to be organic.
Mm-hmm. And the right consistency.
And it had to be delicious.
What was just up is one of the blends that you came up with.
That's the Spicy Sunrise. That's this one right here. It's Spicy Sunrise, so it's beets.
So this is a gorgeous.
Obviously, beets, cucumbers, carrots, orange juice. And then what we do that's different than other juice companies is we do some blending work. So we put flax seeds and pumpkin seeds, we grind them up and put them in there. So you're actually getting your omega fatty acids in the juice. There's no other product on the market that does that. We blend in other items that make it more nutritious.
So you're using the slipperiness of those mm-hmm. to affect the consistency of the juice.
Indeed. We love to use chia seeds because they thicken it up, which makes it feel more like a meal. But they're also adding fiber, and lots of fiber helps to keep the system clean.
And if somebody's really curious about all the ingredients on mm-hmm. these juices we're talking about, they can go to your website,
absolutely.
Right?
So our website is verdefood.com, and we have a menu section, not only the juices, but the rest of our menu, all of our food is there as well.
And we'll talk about the foods mm-hmm. in a bit, because they are delicious,
Thank you. Absolutely delicious,
and mm-hmm. fresh. You can just feel the nutrition into you.
Mm-hmm.
So what other juices did you find helpful during your recovery?
I didn't bring it today, but it's similar to one that we call Rainbow Blitz. It's sort of the kitchen sink of juices. You have the ingredients listed right there. It has a little bit of everything in it, which is basically what I was making for myself.
Oh, here it is.
But if you would just throw all of those ingredients into the smoothie, it would be so thick and globby that your reaction is like, oh, I got to put this in my body. So I was juicing some of the ingredients and blending other ingredients like kale, spinach, parsley. I would put those in as whole leaves. I wouldn't juice them because I wanted to add the fiber back into the juice.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'd put almonds in and I'd use some seeds in there. I think there's pumpkin and chia seeds in there as
well.
So
that's a good point.
Yeah.
So some of the things you're juicing, mm-hmm. which separates the pulp out,
exactly.
and you use the pulp elsewhere.
We do.
And then some of the things you're Vitamix or Blendtex
mm-hmm.
that takes the whole food and blenderizes it.
Right. Well, it's like a blender, but yes, it's a little bit bigger than your average blender. But yes, we grind all of those things down. We make a puree out of them. and then we fold them into the cold pressed juice. You want to protect the integrity of cold pressed juice. It hasn't been heated and it hasn't been oxidized, so it has a very high nutritional value. So we don't want to put our juice in the blender because then you oxidize it or you're adding friction, which could contribute to heat. And heat and oxygen denature vitamin C, which is one of the most valuable antioxidants we can put in our body.
So that's where your business is unique, that you are very careful to preserve the integrity of such enzymes and vitamins.
Indeed. So we never heat any of our juice products, and we work so hard to put extra nutrition in there and protect it. A lot of competitors, you know, they don't spend the time that we do to put the extra nutrition in the bottle.
And we're getting the advantage of you wanting to do this for your recovery.
Indeed. Mm-hmm. And we have a core of about 12 varieties of juice because I got bored, for starters. But also I was seeking nutritional diversity. You don't want to drink beets at every single meal. Mm-hmm. So I needed to have a number of different recipes. And I spent time actually researching the nutritional value of all of the ingredients and striving for a particular balance.
That is excellent. I'm looking at the rainbow blitz that you mentioned. Mm-hmm. And one thing I teach people is eat the rainbow. Mm-hmm. We're attracted to different colors, mm-hmm. and the beautiful foods, mm-hmm. and those pigments that color the foods, mm-hmm. Feed us in very special ways, our eyes, our skin, our immune system, our bones.
Indeed. It can be gosh darned inconvenient, though. Most Americans eat maybe 3, if they're lucky, 4 servings of vegetables a day. That's like you're ahead of the curve if you're an American eating 4 servings of vegetables every day. We should be eating 7 to 9 servings of vegetables and fruit all day long. And that means a lot of salads. It means a lot of washing of vegetables, cutting vegetables, cooking them or chopping them.
Chewing.
Chewing, exactly. And that slows us down because Americans don't like to sit still to eat anything. So instead of eating a salad at every meal, one of the things that we do at Verde is we put the salad in the bottle and say, go, hop in the car and go back to your errands. And you don't have to slow down to eat your salad.
So you're really
done part of that work for them.
You're catering to us. Mm-hmm. Fast food oriented
in a manner
eaters.
Of speaking. I mean, that is what a good quality juice is. It is nutritious food in a very convenient package.
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes. Excellent. Well, you've got a wonderful combination. One that I usually buy is the roots juice.
Right. Yeah, I have that
which
here.
Is that
it's
one.
This guy here, that beautiful orange
yes.
color.
Yes.
And this one is a really basic juice. It only has really 3 ingredients. We throw a little bit of lemon in there as a preservative, but it's carrots, ginger, and turmeric. And those carrots, by the way, at this season, we're starting to get some of our local carrots. We participate with La Montanita Co-op, and they have a distribution branch. So they aggregate local produce, like these carrots, which were locally grown. So great for fighting inflammation.
Excellent. And it is, I'm used to glass.
Right. So we like this one here. This is the beet mocha. This is a seasonal flavor, which is why it's in the glass bottle.
It's so
we've
gorgeous.
Been slowly making the move to plastic bottles. And this is also a slightly smaller size, mm-hmm. Because it lowers the price point for customers. We're a social enterprise. We think everyone should have access to really good quality food. Mm-hmm. And if putting it in a plastic bottle makes it more affordable for our customers, then that's something that we can do.
Interesting. So what's the advantage of glass? What's the advantage of plastic? You said price.
Right. Well, there's price. There's a reusability factor. So this is something else that I know that at a later time we'll talk more about sustainability. But mm-hmm. really, we are focused on trying to have the smallest carbon footprint that we possibly can. Glass is great if you're going to reuse glass.
Right.
And so when we first opened, we were getting 60% of our glass bottles returned to the store where we would wash, sanitize, and reuse them, which mm-hmm. would lower our carbon footprint. Our glass bottle return has dropped well below 40%, which means I know that Verde glass bottles are ending up in the landfill. You know, the city also did away with curbside glass recycling, so even one more reason to think that they're ending up in the landfill. And so that breaks my heart. And plastic bottles, because they have a lower carbon footprint for making the plastic, right? Because you don't have to heat it up so much. To make a brand new glass bottle, you have to heat the components so hot that you use tons and tons of energy.
Wow.
And then if that's a single-use glass bottle, that is much more damaging to the planet than is a plastic bottle that uses so much less so much less energy, but can be recycled more conveniently than the glass can.
Let's go back to your gorgeous juices. We've got some beautiful photographs of, of some of the ingredients that go into the juices. So if we could see those, that'd be great. There's a lot of, this is the immunity tea you're talking about.
Right, so we call it wellness tea. It's made with the immunity shot, which is lemon and ginger, turmeric. We throw some adaptogenic herbs in there. It's an amazing way to boost the immune system.
So that's lemon,
right,
so cayenne.
So that's chamomile tea.
Chamomile.
With ginger, turmeric, lemon, local honey, echinacea, oregano oil and black pepper.
Wow.
And that echinacea and oregano oil are adaptogenic herbs that are antiviral, antibacterial, and they just, it just does an amazing thing for kicking anything out of the system.
And you sell this in what you're calling a shot.
Yes, so that's a 2-ounce shot bottle you have in your hand. So you can just throw the whole thing back as a shot, or you can mix it in with another juice, or like in the case for my children, that wellness tea that we were just showing, I make tea that has extra honey in it because this is strong stuff. I mean, all that ginger and turmeric and lemon, I mean, it's intense. But I can add that to a honey sweetened tea and my kids will gladly drink it, which keeps them back in school.
Well, and local honey is medicinal in itself.
Indeed it is, it is.
Excellent. So you've got some other gorgeous shots of, of some of the ingredients. Oh, the beet mocha.
Right.
Tell us about that.
This is a seasonal. We do it for the holidays. You know, everybody, you know, knows that Starbucks is going to do their pumpkin spice latte as Thanksgiving approaches. At Verde, our customers look forward to the beet mocha, and they start asking for it about September and October. They start getting antsy. The beet mocha is back at Verde, and it's an amazing beverage. This is like one of the best for sports performance, believe it or not. It's fresh, local New Mexico pecan milk that we make ourselves in-house, all organic pecans from New Mexico. We add beet juice, cold brew coffee, which is also an organic coffee, and cacao. We use cacao seeds to make this, and just a touch of local honey, so it's not too sweet. And I kid you not, it tastes like chocolate milk. Or if you serve it hot to your kids, it tastes like hot cocoa. And they think it's cool that it's red. They have no idea that there are vegetables in there.
Does heating it deteriorate some of the benefits?
Sure. So I think if you were to boil it for an extended period of time, then you would probably lose out on a lot more of the nutrition. Iron doesn't go away when you cook it.
No.
One of the reasons for drinking beet,
right?
So beet's not an amazing source of vitamin C. So, but I think the key is don't stick it in the microwave for 5 minutes and then expect there to be a expect it to have the same nutritional value that it did before you put it in the microwave to begin with.
Don't stick it in the microwave.
But if you want to warm it up a little bit and serve it as a hot cocoa to your kids, I think you can feel really confident that you're giving them something that's super delicious and is going to feed their bodies.
Well, you've got some great food, excellent juices and medicinal juices, and you also have some delicious, very nutritious foods.
Thank you.
So you've got a, let's look at the curry, the chicken curry wrap.
The curry chicken wrap. So this surprises a lot of our customers who, they have this conception that Verde is a vegetarian place. You know, we're all about juice, and why would we have animal protein on the menu? Animal protein is a great thing to include in your diet in moderation. You just don't want to overdo it, but we think that we should be eating more and more vegetables in our diet. So one of the things that we do is we sneak the vegetables in. You can see that roasted cauliflower that's in there. So it's about 60% chicken, which is humanely raised organic chicken, the roasted cauliflower, and it's a cashew-based curry dressing that goes into that.
So including the wrap, it's actually more vegetable.
It is more vegetable than it is meat, absolutely. And even that wrap is organic, locally produced tortillas. They come from a
delicious
lovely place
tortilla. It's so moist and fresh. I love it. I love it. It's a really good tortilla. So who makes them?
Cordero tortilla, which is in Taos, New Mexico.
Oh, good. Old Taos.
All organic whole wheat tortillas, and we've been buying them for quite a while.
Oh my gosh, they're mm-hmm. so good. And then you also have a very good breakfast cookie. It's not a dessert cookie.
Not a dessert at all. The breakfast cookie, it's here, I don't know if you, I think you do have a photo, but the breakfast cookie is gluten-free. So again, we don't want any of the fake stuff, so we don't use any refined sugars in it or at all. It's gluten-free. We add teff and sorghum flours, which are naturally high-protein
from
flours.
Africa, right?
Yes, teff is from Africa, indeed. And then we sweeten it with just a little bit of maple syrup, but we add some dried fruit in there. So there's coconut oil in there, the gluten-free flours, it's you think about feeding your kids a bowl of Cheerios for breakfast with all of the sugar and the non-existent nutrients that they put in there. They have to fortify those cereals with outside vitamins and minerals like Ensure to be able to put anything on the side of the box. I mean, this has the actual nutrients right there in it.
That's excellent. That's excellent. And you make happy people by feeding them nutritious foods and foods that are easily available on a 45-minute hour lunch. Mm-hmm. So we've got some happy customers here.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we have a very loyal fan base. And the cafe now is serving lunch 5 days a week. We have a juiced burger you can see right there in that photo. We make the town's best veggie burger, which we do with juice pulp that's a byproduct of juicing.
Excellent. And you have two local stores, right?
We do. We have the main location, which is on San Mateo in Midtown. If you know where Chocolate Maven is and Midtown Bistro, we're right smack in the middle of them. Mm-hmm. And then we have a grab-and-go location just off of the plaza at Marcy and Washington.
And this is what we're seeing now. Mm-hmm. Are we? Yes, right now. Mm-hmm. And for those of you who are watching online, this is a typical shot of downtown Santa Fe,
right,
with
exactly.
the beautiful mm-hmm. wood and the adobe coloring. It's gorgeous. Come
Santa
and visit
Fe's
us.
Santa Fe's a gorgeous place.
Mm-hmm. Yes, 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 yes. How much time do we have left? Okay, good. We got plenty of good time. Mm-hmm. So tell us more about, how did you heal with all this incredible nutrition? Were your doctors surprised?
My doctor was really surprised. He said, 2 months in bed, don't expect to really do anything. After about 3 weeks, I was so bored. I had energy. I sent my mother back home and said, I have to go do something. And so my kids were in school or daycare, I think, preschool, I think it was. Preschool at that point. And so they were out of the house for a while, and I was making smoothies for myself and spent a lot of time looking at the nutritional value and then started sharing my smoothies with the world. And woke up one day and I was making smoothies and juice blends for 10 people every day, and just for the fun of it, because I was doing them anyway for myself. So why not share with friends? And somebody said, you should sell it, and I said, okay. But I healed so much faster than anybody thought that I would.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. And how about your bone strength? How's your bone strength?
I think my
bone density, I should say.
I believe my bone density is pretty great. I've never had a broken bone, but I feel like I should knock on some wood after saying that out loud.
Well, we'll talk a little bit more about, because mm-hmm. where we get calcium in our life is mm-hmm. a hot issue, especially mm-hmm. for women.
Mm-hmm. Vegetables actually are an amazing source of calcium. It's a mineral, and things that grow in the ground soak it up. And so you can actually get calcium from some really surprising sources. And most of us think about, you can really only get calcium from dairy products, which...
Well, that's the brainwashing we've gotten mm-hmm, mm-hmm. by the dairy industry.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. I've gotten into some big arguments with pediatricians when I take my kids in. My oldest daughter has a life-threatening dairy allergy. She has a number of life-threatening allergies.
Wow.
And so when I go into the pediatrician and they say, well, your children should be drinking milk every day. It's the beginning of a long conversation that usually doesn't go well for the doctor.
Well, your kids are going to be strong and healthy and be able to stand up for themselves.
They shall.
Because they
indeed.
Saw their mom do it for them. Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So congratulations.
Thank you.
And how's the business going?
The business is going great. So we have just recently launched into a new endeavor. So not only can you get Verde at our two stores, but we are able to begin wholesaling our juice. So it is now being carried at the Los Alamos Co-op, for example. So you can walk into your local grocery store and ask for Verde. So it's just now begun. So start asking for those grocers to carry Verde. It will be at the Santa Fe Airport and you name it. So look out, Albuquerque, we're coming.
How long do the juices last?
So it depends on which juice. So something like the beet mocha, which is a nut milk based juice, it has a 5-day shelf life as its maximum. For some of our signature juice line, we're actually able to extend the shelf life using a new technology called HPP. It's high pressure processing, so we're still never heating the juice. It stays below 40 degrees, but we use high pressure in a hyperbaric chamber to denature certain types of bacteria, not even all of the bacteria, but certain types of bacteria are susceptible to this pressure. Mm-hmm. They tend to be the harmful pathogens that you don't want to get, that lead to illness, such as E. coli, is completely destroyed by pressure because it has a weak cell wall. And so that can extend the shelf life and make it safer longer.
Mm-hmm. Excellent. Well, we've got some other food items that we haven't even talked about yet. Mm-hmm. We've got some excellent pecans and walnuts mm-hmm. that are flavored.
Right. So again, usually when you buy nuts that, you know, snack nuts that have some sort of a flavoring on them, mm-hmm. People have done some really outrageous things. They've coated them with so much sugar, and we don't believe in over-sugaring anything. So our maple fennel pecans just have a hint of organic maple syrup on them. But then the walnuts, these are really interesting. I had somebody actually ask for the recipe once, and I was glad to share it with them, but it takes 3 days to make them. So we sprout all of our nuts first, because that takes away an inhibitor enzyme, which makes them hard to digest. Great. So we sprout all of our nuts, and that takes about 24 hours. And then we marinate them for about another 24 hours. So those seasoned walnuts are marinated in a turmeric dressing. Mm-hmm. So it soaks up all of that lovely East Indian flavor. And then we dehydrate them. So they have a nice long shelf life and they crisp up, but they haven't been heated. We don't roast our nuts like other people do, which really removes a lot of the nutritional value.
Well, we've got almost one more minute. Mm-hmm. So there's other food items available. There's salads, there's, next show we'll talk more about some of the non-dairy calcium sources. Mm-hmm. So you've been watching New Mexico's Naturopathic Medical Show. We have Kelly Egolf from Verde Food Company here in Santa Fe, New Mexico. Please watch our next show with Kelly. Thanks, Harvey and Dottie, for running camera. Thank you, George, for directing.